Happy Wednesday, team. All right, so yesterday I did a little bit of a video in the devotional video, and I gave a little bit of a teaser, as I was calling it. And of course, me, I can't. I'm like an old woman, and I can't stop myself. I was so excited about the John 3:16 devotional team shirts and what the cause was for. I gave these a little too much, but anyways, today, team, I have my 35 plus year, I would say it, right? That's dating us, your friend. Pastor Steve Trolio, PS, we call him Trooper or PS, and I told you guys he is here with his wife Jara, our dear family friends, and they are going to do our wedding vows this Saturday. Me and little Mel are renewing our 10-year wedding vows, and but I told her it's only Wednesday. I still have a little thinking to do if I'm going to actually show up on Saturday.
You know, if she sees you, your face is going to be on a milk carton.
Thank God that she's in the other room with PS's wife, Chera, and they're trying on dresses, and I can't see them. So I'm talking all tough, but they can't hear me.
Yeah,
So,
they know.
anyways,
She knows.
she knows. So
She
they're
knows.
here in town doing that because PS is the one who married us 10 years ago. So this was, this was part of the tradition. So I am going to let Trooper, Pastor Steve, talk about the Bags of Hope, where these shirts, where all the profit, all the proceeds from these shirts are going to.
Yeah, well, first of all, it's good to be here. I get a chance every now and then to watch my little brother here do his devotionals, and man, it just brings joy to my heart, man. It really does. You
Yeah,
know that.
I know it does.
So the Bags of Hope. Did you tell him how it came about? What you decide how it came about with the t-shirts? You
Yes.
called me last week. And what we do, we pastor a church in the southwest side of Chicago. It's 19 years old. It's called the Firehouse Chapel. And about 4 years ago, my daughter and my wife had found out that there was a need. I can't remember exactly how it happened, but the need was this. A lot of the schools where we live, and again, we're in a suburb, so people wouldn't think this, but it's happening all over our country. There are kids that are on public aid and free lunches and free breakfast at school. Well, when they go home on Friday, they don't get another meal until Monday. And my daughter came to me and met with my wife and said, "Listen, we got to do something. What can we do?" And so they started talking about getting food. We did it originally in book bags. We bought like, I think, 100 book bags, and every Friday they were packed full of food, canned goods, boxes of the mac and cheese and stuff that was non-perishable. Kids would take the backpacks home so they wouldn't, be singled out, and then they would have food through the weekend. And this thing has just exploded on us. Last year, we fed over 3,400 kids in the school year. I think we spent $36,000 or $37,000 in food, which is just awesome. Every penny of it was
Huge.
paid for.
Yeah.
And but now the food demand has gotten so big, we don't have a book bag anymore. We have boxes. This company that we've never met up near O'Hare donated 1,000 boxes. We put them together and then we stuff them full of food. And so we never get to meet the families. So every 2 weeks we deliver, when I get back home, I'll deliver 40 boxes to the one local school. Then I think there's 10 other schools that we're in. And so the social worker, we give them all the social workers, then the social workers distribute to the families. We never meet them. And then at Christmas time last year, we wanted to do something special for Christmas. So what we did was we were only going to get a $100 gift card for one family out of each school. And I said to my daughter, I said, "Why don't we get one gift card to Walmart for every family?" Well, some families have 8 kids. So we ended up getting $8,500 worth of gift cards to Walmart last year. So that's all part of the program. So what this does is when kids go home on Friday, they're bringing home these big boxes of food. And it's enough. Sometimes it's not enough just for those kids, but for their entire families to go the weekend. And I tell you what, it gets me choked up every time.
Yeah. And listen, it became dear to my heart a few years ago, of course, with the children and stuff. And I don't like to ever put anything out there, but that's close to mine and Melissa's heart, and that's where we tied to and stuff. And we've had some great people come in and give donations and tithe, and it's been amazing. But as you guys out there were saying to me all the time, when you'd see I'd put the John 3:16 devotional team on my bodybuilding shirts, and you guys would always ask, how can I buy one? How can I buy one? And they were never for sale because they go just to the athletes from the show. That's our present back to the athletes. They give them a nice shirt. And so that's how it was going. But you guys prompted me to, and God put it on my heart about this John 3:16 team. And I said, this would be amazing if we can get these shirts done for a very reasonable price, sell them for a very reasonable price, and all the proceeds are going to the kids, to the children, to the Bags of Hope, right? So that started it. I prayed about it. I called PS about it, and I said, Trooper, this is what's on my heart. He said, oh, that's an awesome idea. I'm going to pray with you on it. And then a few days later, only it was a few days, this has been came quickly, I called my dear friend Aaron Singerman, who owns Redcon One, who the supplement company, and this is one of his shirts right here, actually. Real nice, and these actually. Our shirts are just form-fitted. They fit. They come in huge sizes, small sizes, and they're just amazing quality shirts. And I said, Aaron, can you hook me up with your shirt guy? This is what I want to do. And when Aaron heard the idea, Aaron said to me, Mel, that's amazing. I love that idea. And he goes, and right now, because I'm going to tell you something, he goes, I am donating $5,000 to the cause. He goes, the first $5,000 of your shirt order is on me. I said, Aaron, oh my God, that is amazing. These kids are going to get such a blessing. Then I called the shirt guy by the name of Craig Herman, who does all the shirts. He's in Boca Raton too. This is in Florida. And I talked to him about it. Aaron told him what was going on. And he said, Mel, I am even going to help out, and I am going to make the shirts I'm going to cut my cost out of it. So I'm like, okay, this, Lord, you got this. You're designing it. You're putting this together. This is going to be a blessing. So we are going to get the shirts up and running, and I'm going to give you guys a sneak peek.
They're real nice.
At the shirts.
Yeah.
This is the black one. The women's are obviously the V-neck. The men's are hair. I know it's a little hard to see, and we tried to blow it up, but it made it worse, guys. It says John 3:16 with the cross is the nails. And then that's the black one. It says John 3:16 devotional team, and it says believe.
Yeah.
All in right there. And here is the white one, men and women's. V-neck and regular ones. Get a little closer. You could see it says John 3:16 devotional team, believe. It's super clean. You can wear these shirts to dinner. You can wear them anywhere. They're not just gym shirts, you guys. They're shirts to go out in. You can wear them ever. They're so comfortable. So we got that in the process. He just sent these over today just so we can approve them and say what we liked. And we'll start out with just the black and white. We don't know the price on the shirt yet. We're thinking somewhere if it's going to be about $20. And usually a shirt like this usually costs about $7 to $8 once it's all made and everything like that. And then the shipping.
Yeah, so, shipping's not cheap.
Yeah, so we're going to figure out what it is because, of course, we want the biggest profit to be of it's all going to the kids. And I said to Trooper, I said, well, okay, we got to make sure that this is, for me, it's accountable. I need to be accountable. I never want nobody down the road saying, Mel's got, I just can't have that. So this is all going to be on the computer. We're going to put it up on the Chansey Fitness site, where to order, you know, when it gets time to order, you know, the shipping will be right in on that and everything. Any donations, not just for the shirts, but if anybody, there's going to be a donation button, anybody wants to give a donation troop, then they get a receipt.
Yeah, they can do it a couple different ways. Well, first of all, with the shirts, what I told Mel when we talked about the shirts is for him and I to wear shirts that have that on there, that's part of our life. That's always been mine since I came to know Christ. It's been his since he's come to know Christ. But for some of you, this may be an awesome opportunity for you to be a billboard for Christ without saying a word.
Right.
Without saying a word. And as Melvin's wife, Melissa, did a phenomenal job putting this together, so it's just a clean, good, straightforward, God-loving message on the shirt, which is awesome.
Yeah.
So how it can happen is you go to Chansey Fitness and you can order a shirt for whatever he ends up saying is the cost, and then once a month, Chansey Fitness will write a check to the Firehouse Chapel, designated Bags of Hope, boxes, whatever. And that fund then goes into our food account at our church. Some people said, well, what if we just want to give directly to that? We don't want the shirt. But again, I'm saying you get a shirt too.
Yeah, please.
But if you give a donation right to the firehouse, we have an online giving opportunity. You go to the firehousechapel.org, firehouse, one word, firehousechapel.org, and you click on the give button, and it takes you to an outside link. It's called Rebel Give. And there's a thing, I think it says Bags of Hope. You click on that, you designate how much money you want to give. You can give, I don't know, through a debit card. I don't have a debit card, so I don't
know. Yeah, we're lost.
Yeah, through a debit card, you can write, they can go into your checking account, however. So the bottom line is, so you click that, the donation comes straight to the firehouse, and then that is put into the account for the kids. You will then get a receipt, not from the firehouse, but you'll get it through Rebel Give, because it's all part of the non-for-profit 501(c), which you keep for your taxes at the end of the year, and then you can apply it to your taxes. So all that, that's how it's all going to work. And then, like I said, once a month, you guys, you know, however it works with your bookkeeper.
And Chansey Fitness will be writing the check from all the proceeds of this right to the firehouse, right to the Bags of Hope. And we will be posting it on here, because I'm with you guys daily for the devotionals, and I will be keeping you guys up to date on everything. Okay, so listen, not to cut it short, but we are at 11 minutes and we only get 15 on this. So I was excited. I couldn't wait for today to get him on here so we could tell you guys about these shirts and what an amazing cause this is for. And we are going to be helping them children out. And the John 3:16 team does not disappoint, as we always say. So that was the surprise, guys. But I want PS to close us in prayer.
All right, okay? Let's pray. Father, I thank you, Lord, for first of all, for Mel and Melissa, and for their willingness and their openness to you. I thank you for what, God, you are doing through this devotional team, through people from all over the world. I pray, God, your blessing. I pray, God, that you minister to the needs and to each and every life that is out there that hears this and shares in these devotionals with Mel, that, God, that you'll continue to bless and guide and direct. Lord, I pray each and every person would come to know you in their heart as their Lord and Savior. As God, as we both have discovered that is the only true way. I pray a blessing on the opportunity that lies ahead. We pray a blessing on these children as that we have the opportunity to be the hands and feet of Christ. In Jesus' name we pray and ask. Amen.
Amen. Okay, team. I'm excited. PS is excited. And I know you guys are excited, because since you've seen the video yesterday, I've been getting a lot of messages. People were like, where can I? I said, hold on, let us get it going. Let's get the shirts up there. Because the real thing is, like Trooper just said, it's we want the people to wear the shirts. You know, like for us, it's nothing. But for some people, putting that on is a strong step of faith.
Can I tell you something real quick? Because we got a minute or so. Just last week, we got contacted by a local school. An 18-year-old girl who's basically living... She has an apartment now in the city. She had to get out of a bad situation. She moved. She takes a bus once a week to come to school. She's working. She has to finish her senior year. She didn't have food, hygiene products, and something else my daughter told me. So right away, my wife and daughter went to Target, Walmart, got her food, got her hygiene products, got her gift card to stuff. That's what we get to do, and that's what we get to do more of, which is just awesome.
And that's a blessing for us all.
It is.
We are interceding for one another. Yep. We are helping out. We are shining the Lord's peace and love with our brothers and sisters, and that is a blessing to us. Okay, you guys, I love yous, and I was excited for this, and God willing, see yous in the morning.
God bless.